Good afternoon, Duke fans. I hope you're enjoying your summer. I am today. I'm happy to be sitting down with Duquesne University football head coach, Coach Jerry Schmitt. I'm your host, Jay Spinks. Thanks for tuning in to another episode of Duke's One-on-One. A little bit about Coach Schmitt for those who may not know. Coach Schmitt just completed his seventh season here at Duquesne University as head coach. You led Duquesne University to 3 MAC championships and to its first ever Northeastern Conference championship this past season, as well as you returned back to Duquesne to return as head coach from your alma mater, which was Westminster College. Coach Schmitt, with the accolades that you've received this far in your career, and the history that you're responsible for when it comes to Duquesne football, what's the one thing that motivates you to continue to strive for success and more year after year when it comes to coaching?
Well, I tell you, Jay, after I'm close to 30 years here coaching overall, and the thing that really drives me now, and I look back on it, always has, is the opportunity to work with student athletes and develop them as young people throughout their career. The wins, the championships, that's all a bonus and icing on the cake. And I feel great for those young men to be able to achieve those goals. But to see them develop also in the classroom, and especially as young people, they come in as freshmen and they leave as seniors, and they're mature, and to see the difference in the way they handle themselves, that's what's really special about it, and that's what drives me every day. Is I learned from my coaches, through high school and college, and they put me in a position to be successful. So I hope to give back and do some of the things they did for me, and just give a little bit back to the players.
Coach Schmitt, looking back on last season, what does it mean to you and Duquesne football program as a whole to have had 11 of your players earn postseason NEC awards?
It's always a great honor for young men to get recognized individually. It's a special achievement for them because they're recognized by the other coaches and the other people in the industry that pick them out. We know they're special here, but to have other people recognize them, it's very special. We also know that when they achieve those awards, it's a team game, and they would not have been able to achieve them without the help of not only the guys that line up next to them, but the guys that practice with them and work with them throughout the whole season. We talk about that all the time in our team. And I think our guys are really humble. They do a nice job of recognizing their teammates and the work that we do and the family that we've built here at Duquesne University in our football program.
Coach Schmitt, here's something that you touch on all the time. As we take a dive into recruiting and look at the roster, at the seasons and year after year, how important is it that you recruit for character and players that model what Duquesne University is all about, rather than just strictly going after those who have talent?
Well, that's an interesting aspect of the recruiting part. You're attracted to the talent that a young man has, but if he's not the right fit for our football program, for our university, for our campus here, then things won't go as smooth as you would like, and he can't be as successful as maximize his ability and potential. And then as a team, we cannot maximize ours. So we do a really good job of looking into what type of person he is, his academic background. We talk to coaches and teachers and parents and want to know what type of person we're bringing to this campus and bringing to our family, our football family. So it's an interesting aspect of it. We work really hard at it. And at this time of the year, it's interesting because we have usually a number of guys that maybe want to transfer in, and they're coming from another program. And we really do our due diligence to find out what makes them tick and the reason they want to be here. And if they're, no matter how talented they are, if they're not coming for the right reasons and we don't think they'll be a fit for our program, then we don't think it'll work out.
Coach Schmitt, this part of the show is called the 5 and 5, which means you have 5 seconds to answer each of the 5 questions. Think you ready?
I'm ready for it.
All right, and we will begin now. First 5 and 5 question: what was the most exciting moment of the 2011 season for you?
Finishing the game at Robert Morris and crowning our guys champions.
Second 5-on-5 question, what is the most exciting part about coaching?
Working with young men and developing them throughout their career.
Third 5-on-5 question, what is one word to describe your 2011 season?
Special.
Fourth 5-on-5 question, who is the most high maintenance player that you've coached this far?
5 seconds. I think our quarterback, Sean Patterson, it's fun coaching him. It's fun.
Sean Patterson, the most high maintenance player, Coach Schmitt is coach. The last 5-on-5 question, you ready?
I'm ready for it.
Last 5-on-5 question, Coach. One word to describe the feeling that you get during game day.
Intensity.
Coach Schmitt, if you could give us some insight about what goes on in the football program after the players leave campus, does it consist of a bit of recruiting still? Does it consist of summer camps or some operations in preparation for summer camp? Can you let us know what goes on behind the scenes during the summer?
Well, finals is usually the first week of May. The whole month of May, our staff is all out with spring recruiting, which is we're evaluating the prospects for next year's recruiting class. That'll take up the entire month of May. Once we get back off of that, we start to do in-house evaluations in the month of June with film and transcripts and setting up our priority boards and evaluating who we're going to recruit through the next year. Also in the month of June, we work camps, football camps. We have our own. We have two of them here on campus, and then we go out and work some other colleges' camps so that we're able to work the camps and work with those young men for future years and get to meet them and work with them. July is mainly our preparations for fall camp when we come back and for the season. We try to knock that out in a couple weeks. We've been doing some of that through spring ball. And then as we get that finished and completed, then we're able to take a couple weeks to relax with our families and take some vacation time in the month of July before we come back in August and we report the first Sunday in August. And from there, it's go.
Go time. Coach Schmitt, lastly, if you could give some advice to a young guy aspiring to play football at the collegiate level, what would that advice be?
Well, the first thing is to be the best they can be on the field and in the classroom. Those are two key components. From a recruiting standpoint, the thing about it is that we always talk about and we tell our recruits is just to communicate, be open and be honest. When I say be open, understand there's a lot of different schools and different levels of schools, both football-wise, athletic-wise, and then academic-wise, that you could find would be the right fit for you. And the same goes for, when they come in to all these, this whole process with the camps and everything, don't get overwhelmed by it. Enjoy the process because this is one time in your life that you go through this recruiting process and enjoy it, communicate, be honest, be open. And in the end, the whole situation will work itself out and go with your gut. Go with the guidance of your parents and your coaches, and usually the right thing will happen for you.
Duke fans, I hope you enjoyed yourselves. Special thanks to head football coach, Coach Jerry Schmitt. I'm your host, Jay Spinks. Thanks for tuning in to another episode of Duke's 101.